Hi, today is 2nd of March 2020 and right now the time is 10:25:26 coming soon, PM. And in just a few minutes, in less than 5 minutes, the US market is going to open and this is going to be a quick recording because been swamped the whole day doing a lot of project, watching the market, and I'm going to share with you a quick update why I think the market is bouncing. But before I share that, which is going to have some educational value, do remember that if you are watching this, do remember from YouTube, do remember to join the Facebook Gathering of Traders. Do remember to join Telegram Gathering of Traders. Search, go to open up a Telegram and search by the Gathering of Traders. You'll be able to find this group. And do remember to subscribe to this YouTube channel, like this YouTube channel, and share this YouTube channel with all your trading friends. And I really appreciate it. That very, very much. Okay, so going to share with you a few educational materials and for you to watch the market first. Okay, but if you notice right now, the market is set for a choppy session. Stimulus measure is in focus, like this morning, Malaysia, Singapore time. Japan basically said they will do whatever it takes. Now, if you take a look at Forex Factory, okay, you will notice that's today. You will notice that the China numbers are really bad. But 11 o'clock, we got ISM manufacturing. So we're going to see whether in about 30 minutes, whether the US market are being affected by the shutdown around the world of the COVID-19 sickness. Okay. And you notice that Australia is going to speak tomorrow. Carney, British pound, British is going to speak tomorrow. And Canada is going to speak on Wednesday. OPEC meetings, definitely, which because oil is dropping like crazy. Carney is going to speak again. Canada is going to speak again. And you will notice that next week, I'm going to share with you because the next few weeks, I won't be able to do a detailed YouTube because starting from this Friday, I will be traveling. Okay. Monetary, Christine Lagarde is going to speak next Thursday, Malaysia, Singapore time, 8:45. And then on the March 19, that will be the FOMC. So back to back for this week, next week, and the week after, a lot of people will be speaking. And the biggest thing, of course, everyone is going to speak is the massive, the fastest market dropped ever for the one entire week, okay? In terms of points, not in terms of percentage, okay? In terms of points, if you look at Dow Jones, because everyone understand the points, you will notice that, yeah, I mean, look at that, okay? From about, what, 29,500, and we dropped down to as low as 24,600, don't know the mathematics, but it's quite bad. Okay. Percentage wise, it is not that bad because the market has gone up like crazy. Monthly chart. If I look at 2008, this was the bad one. You notice it's not that bad. This is the monthly chart. And if you remember to watch the YouTube, okay, for the last week, 2 weeks ago, I was talking about this bearish candle right there. The market has dropped tremendously since then. Okay, so the biggest note everyone is wondering will be, are we at support? We were quite close, okay, but mainly, come on, okay, computer a bit lagging, mainly we stopped right there. Not only because of this, actually it's not because of 61. Hello. Computer, don't hang. Okay. It's actually because of this support that was in May 2019. Okay. Now, you notice that S&P on Friday, it was bad, but we had that bullish candle. Okay. And this morning, we gapped down, came down, and everyone say, it's going to be bad. Everyone start shorting. But let me share with you a little bit of educational material first, all right? Now, for those of you, I'm going to pick this chart. This is Constellation brand. And what's so special about this is because this is the manufacturer of, I mean, the parent company of Corona beer. Just as example, okay? You will notice that if you understand one of my trading setup is I love the hammer pattern, okay? And a lot of people this morning, they basically give up and don't want to look at that any of the trading or start shorting, because whenever they open up their trading platform, it is all red color. That means the market is dropping and crazy, very bad, okay? So let me share with you a little bit piece of education that you may not realize, or some of you may already know. So this for those of you who may not realize. You will notice that I'm using this Constellation brand. On a hindsight, you will notice that a Friday candle was bullish. It is white candle. Okay, why? It's because the closing price is higher than the opening price. So you notice that on the chart, it is white. And you will be, how to say, you will be excited to look at this candle. However, if you just look at your trading platform without any candlestick, you will not even want to look at this particular chart. For one main reason, if you go and, example, you open up your broker platform, it is red in color. So to you, everything that's red in color, I don't like it. But you will realize one thing. It is red in color because it is the current price is comparing to the previous closing price. So if you take a look at here, this was the previous closing price. Even though the candle is white, but your broker platform will show this counter as red color, because even though it closed here, which is below the previous candle close, of course this counter will be red. And it will be in minus. But look at the chart. This is a bullish candle. So which is why a lot of people, every time they look at the candle and say, oh, really bad. No. I mean, look at the price. No, look at the candle formation. We had a gap down, came down, and tried to push higher. So right now, the price you should be watching is this. The high.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay. I'm running some process at the background, testing some process. So you should be paying attention to the high, Friday's high. Okay. Now, we did went higher during the afternoon. But if you notice the market update that I posted yesterday, I said the real move should be in the late afternoon or evening when the US is actually trading. Is there bad news in US? They are starting. It is now no longer Asia problem. COVID-19 is Europe problem. It is starting to be an American problem. Starting. But it is not that bad yet. Okay? We are right now drastically oversold. I'm expecting a technical rebound. And if COVID-19 starts spreading, we will be jumping down. So in other words, right now, this is a counter trend trade. Disclaimer, whatever I share is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. I'm going to take a look at the daily candle. So on my the other screen, so I can share with you what are the chart. S&P. I mean, look at that. It's bullish. So look, pay attention to the Friday's high. Okay. Now, NASDAQ, surprisingly, is the strongest. Well, not surprisingly, mainly because it is highly speculative. Look at how big that body is and look at this 200. It is all being supported by this 200. So NASDAQ, look at that. We are now very close to the body high. Whereas Dow Jones, look at that, not yet. S&P, not yet. Okay? So, London. Look at that. Look at how beautiful is that candle. Okay. Not only that, we have actually not much. China, we tried. China did try. Because Germany is not. Okay, I'll show you Germany. Not Germany. Yes, Germany. Yeah. GER30, yes. DAX is not. The difference is the trading hours. DAX not so nice. But GER is nice. That's a cash contract. Where's the China? Yeah. We tried. Okay, still good, still bullish, but we got to break through this 200 as our resistance right at this moment. Early today, we got a very nice bearish candle in the dollar cat. Look at that. We had a nice one, and right now it's trying to retrace to see whether can we go somewhere here and see whether any bearish candle on a smaller time frame before opportunity to shoot it down. Okay, now do take note, this dollar cat will be also, this oil is going to play a role with dollar cat. Oil is trying to do a rebound. Okay, so if rebound, that will affect the dollar cat, so which is why. Okay, now a question was asked because they're not sure. You notice that if I share with you all the world indices, you can basically say world indices like Dow Jones, Germany DAX, London are bullish. So usually when I say the world indices are bullish, usually it is easy. I mean, that means most of the world should go up. Let's just put it this way. US dropped so much, it is hard for Germany to go up. Am I right? Okay, so generally in world indices, you can say generally it is bullish or bearish. But in currency, you cannot say all currency are bullish or all currency generally are bearish, because it is the formula. Okay, I was using example, Euro USD and USD JPY. Can Euro USD and USD JPY both are bullish? It is possible. It is possible. I show you a chart. I mean, if you want, you can always check and compare the chart yourself. Okay. Window. Now horizontal. Okay. So you will notice that, like right here. Okay. Right here. See, generally, euro dollar goes up, dollar yen comes down. Generally. But there will be certain situation where euro dollar goes up, like here, dollar yen also goes up. Okay, but you cannot say that with generally currency. It's because euro USD. That's the mathematical term. USD JPY. Okay, now you cannot say euro US dollar goes up, bullish bias. That means US dollar yen goes up, bullish bias. Or even worse, euro divided by yen also bullish. So you can't state that statement. I hope this is a mathematical, I don't know how to explain it, but basically you cannot have a bullish bias in general currency. I mean, you cannot make that type of statement. But can the price go higher at the same time? There are certain time, as I give you in this example, like right here. Okay, but mathematically you cannot say currency are bullish or currency are bearish. It's more specific. World indices, you can make that general statement. Okay, but yeah, sometimes Dow Jones go up, Singapore futures come down, or Dow Jones has been going up for the last 2 years, Malaysia KLCI has been downtrend for the last 2 years. Okay, so this is a quick message sharing with you that right now market is extremely oversold, and there are trading opportunities on a smaller time frame. US right now just opened and we are coming down. That's good, because I'm looking for trading opportunity to see whether got long, such as this afternoon in Germany DAX, 15 minute, my signal. Right there. Nice one. Okay, out already, because the signal for the 15 minute should last you 3 to 5 candles only. Not enter on a 15 minute and then stay on for days. It doesn't work that way. Okay, it's only lasting 3 to 5 candles. Good enough bounce. Just now there was a silver was trying to bounce, there was a bounce here. You notice a lot of this never hit entry price. Okay, so quick one. Generally, world indices expecting a technical bounce, but if this bounce does happen, we will form a bear flag for it to go lower. Put an alert on last Friday low. We break that last Friday low, we're going to jump down. We're going to go all the way down. So last Friday low is a support, okay? A technical support. And if I draw a Fibonacci on the opposite direction, this will be how high I am expecting the market to bounce. And if it does goes up all the way here, which I doubt 61, but it is possible, I'm looking for bearish candle to start shorting. Disclaimer applies. All right, so quick one, because I'm traveling this Friday. So this is a quick update. Say that right now, volatility is here. I mean, take a look. You want to know? Look at today's candle. Today's candle. In comparison for Dow S&P, look at that. How big. We haven't seen that one day. I mean, the last 1 week is equivalent. Look at that. The volatility is here. Fantastic opportunity to start to trade. I do understand that, yes, because the daily candles are huge, so it's hard to trade daily candle because your stop loss is very big. So in order to minimize your risk, you have to trade very small. But the problem with trading very small size, because your stop loss is very big, because the candles are huge, it's just not worth trading. Trade very small size because of the huge stop loss, and the profit you make is small. So now is the best time with high volatility to trade intraday, the smaller time frame candle, like 15 minute, 30 minute, hourly. All right, so Jonathan, till the next time, I most probably will do some Facebook Live on the road to update you. See you and be safe. Bye.